this cheap little Chinese LED light bulb, candelabra base, was being used as a reading lamp for a couple of years probably, but as you can see, it's finally given up on me. So nothing left to do but tear it down and see why it broke. If it and if there's any reason for me to have expected it not to have broken. Knife here, cut the little seal or voltage thing, I guess. Yes, it was 110 volts. Oh, and is it gonna come open without? No, so I'm gonna have to do some abuse on it here. As you can see, there's a groove molded into the base and a ring that's clipped into it, molded into the plastic cap on it here. So I'm just gonna have to break that and pry it apart. I don't think there's any way to do this gently, but I think I'll spare you the horrors. Or I could just pry it apart like that. I did not expect that to work. Okay, are you going to come out of there easily? No. So, how am I going to get that out? There we go. That wasn't quite as ugly as I had thought. Okay, what do we got here? Looks like a fairly standard capacitive dropper. Neutral live. Live goes through the capacitor, which is a 250 volt. 250 volt, 225 joules, CBB22 dot. There's that, and it's got a little resistor across it to discharge it so that you don't blow yourself up. Then it looks like it goes through the full bridge rectifier, smoothing capacitor, couple of 62 ohm resistors. They look like they're in parallel, probably in series with that. Another little resistor there, and then this capacitor, which is a 4.7 microfarad 400 volt, which we're going to assume is in parallel with all the LEDs. So all the LEDs in this one is 56 of them. There's 8 sets of these 6, plus this top one, which has 8 on it. And now that I'm getting closer here and look, see the black dot there and a black dot there? That is pretty typical of LEDs that have died. Is there any more? No, but, well, there might be some. But regardless, these are all in series sets by the looks of it. Each of these little boards, you see, you've got a positive there, negative there. The next one is positive at that end, negative at that end. Chug, chug, chug all the way along. So somewhere down the bottom here, you can see little tabs sticking through that just mechanically mount those. Somewhere down here, we're going to find where this begins and ends and goes onto the board. There, that looks like a set of vias there. That comes up onto the board over here. And that looks like another set of vias there. So I'm going to guess that this one and this one are the beginning and end, probably. And then at some point, yeah, there's a set of vias up there. It goes on to the top of this. What can we assume? Maybe about 3 volts per LED times 56 of them in series. 168 volts DC? Maybe. I think I found a little bit safer way to play with this thing, at least initially. I've got my power supply here set to 3 volts, basically. 20 milliamps. So we'll see if we can just light up any one of these LEDs. Whoa, there we go. Oh, they're in pairs. Okay. So, in that case, it's, what's half of 56? 25, 28, 28 times 3 volts. So it's going to be 84 volts across that thing. That makes me feel a little bit less cavalier playing with it. Let's see, where's those LEDs that have the black spots on them? There we go. Nothing there. Nothing there. Yeah, what about the pair below them? Okay, so that pair works. This pair is blown up. And then on each alternate board, the polarity is different. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, how about up here on the top? Okay. So I'm wondering if it's just that pair that blew out. That might make it fixable if I have any LEDs of this size. Oh, there's some warm whites. Okay, I should be able to steal a couple of LEDs off there and put it on there. See if I can get that thing working. Now I just have to desolder stuff. I think I'm going to start with my iron and see if I can do that. And if that doesn't work, I'll move on to the hot air station. Yeah, that doesn't want to work. Okay, let's try the hot air and see if that'll work. I am not at all accustomed to using this tool, so I may melt everything but what I'm intending to melt. That came off fairly easily. Okay, well, that was painless. Let's see if I can get these off here just as easily. One, and you notice I've marked the negative end with a little bit of a black Sharpie mark. Ow, my finger. Two. Wow. This hot air is an interesting thing to play with. I'm going to have to use that more often. Let's put a dot of solder on one side, in this case the negative side. Oh, this might be challenging because this is one of those aluminum core circuit boards. So theoretically, I should be able to melt that end down. Stop laughing. And then just put a wee dot of solder on this end. And again, I'm sure I'm going to put too much on. But so be it. I wonder if that one even still works. And it still works. Okay. One down, one to go. Okay, maybe? Let's see. So there, now I got 9 volts on there. Still got it limited at 20 milliamps though. So we'll see what happens. Ho ho! That's a good sign. I should probably test all the other strips too. But I'm pretty confident that they all work. How cocky should I get? Should I just put this put power on this thing and try it? Yes, I shall. So this should be safe. It's in the rubbery jaws of the vise. So there's that. There's that. Switch on. Well, that was anticlimactic. But while I've got that in the gingerly held in the rubber jaws of the vise, I'm gonna carefully probe that capacitor. 40 volts, 39 volts, 38 volts. It's a bit lower than we thought, isn't it? What did we math out here earlier? 56 LEDs, but they're in pairs, so there's 28 of them. Multiplied by 3 volts, should be about 84 volts. Huh, what's drawing that down? That might be a problem. I'm thinking that that's just from my rough handling of it. Let's just toss a little bit of flux in there just for fun. Just a little bit. And I've got a slightly larger tip on my iron here to retain some heat. There. That was easy. Ha 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 ha! There we go. Well, that's excellent. Shall we just see if my prediction was correct on that capacitor, on that voltage? It'll be easier if you could see the meter. That's pretty darn close. 82.2 volts DC across the LEDs. Excellent. Now then, how much damage did I do to it mechanically when I took it apart? You were folded down there, and you were kind of folded down there. And you guys all stuffed into there. Yeah, that fits. And the little pill bottle-y cap. Well, that looks right. Ta-da! Okay, that's a surprising result. I didn't actually expect that I'd be able to fix that thing. And quite honestly, it's a pointless repair, because to replace this would only cost me $2.34 from random eBay sellers. So, should I have done this? Probably not. It was a cool exercise though, and I got to practice surface mount soldering. There's the pair that I replaced there. And they look pretty similar to their neighbors. If they were in alignment, you probably couldn't tell the difference. Zoom back out a little bit and let my exposure straighten itself up. But yeah, that was fun. Pointless, but fun. Thanks for watching. As always, I really do appreciate it. Comments, complaints, questions down below. Tell me how crazy I was to actually have done this and that I shouldn't have done that and nobody else should do this at home. I know that. But yeah, you can yell at me anyway. I don't care. Yeah, thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.